For a long time, I've been wondering and trying to figure out why some people have addiction and why some don't. Why do some people able to drink socially and other people, when they drink too much? Why can some people even try other drugs? Some people get put on opioids for pain from a doctor's office and they just stop taking it, but other people keep going and it gets them in all kind of trouble and ends up leading to addiction. And for the is the major cause of that, and a big surge in dopamine. When people use drugs, they get a big surge of dopamine in their nucleus accumbens, or their pleasure center. And it seems that when people get that, they really value that and they keep doing it over and over again. And that really still is a huge part of what, leads people back to using drugs, is that that pleasure is so intense that they want to keep doing it. But lately, there's been more and more evidence that, in addition to that, and maybe even more important than that, part of the disease of addiction is what happens to the frontal lobes of the brain, what we call the orbitofrontal cortex, or really the thinking part of the brain, the part of the brain that makes decisions. Because it turns out that's a really important part of the whole disease process. It's what sort of explains why people would go back to using drugs even when they're through their withdrawal period. Maybe they've been in jail for 3 months or 6 months or even 5 years. But most people without treatment, without working a program, go back to using drugs even when it makes absolutely no sense. It turns out that when people get a big dopamine spike from using drugs that cause this intense experience, it sends messages to the frontal lobes that actually changes the pathways in that part of the decision-making part of the brain. And it poisons that part of the brain where it's really almost impossible for people to make sensible decisions. It's a little bit like someone who's in a bad love relationship and they end up deciding to stay with someone who's really abusive, or they end up making excuses for them, or they downplay how dangerous it is or how painful it is and stuff like that. People with drugs do the same thing. They downplay, they just don't see just how much it's hurting them and how much it's hurting other people. They have real trouble making risk evaluations of what's a safe thing to do and what's not a safe thing. Just in the last couple of days, I was talking to a patient who really doesn't want to continue with his treatment program because he thinks he doesn't need any treatment. And yet, he's failed treatment many, many times before. And common sense says that he really needs to stick with his program and stay in therapy and stay on his medication. So, the truth is that drug addiction poisons the thinking part of the brain in such a way that it leads people to be unable to see reality really clearly in terms of how risky things are and how to make decisions to not give in to impulses, to have good ability to withstand cravings and stuff like that. So, knowing that, it's really important that people, of course, stay off drugs and use things like naltrexone so that they can decrease their cravings, but also really work a program so that they go to therapy, they surround themselves with healthy people, they engage in activities that are passionate and meaningful for them, they go to support groups and stuff like that so they're around people with hope, and they, over time, in some ways grow up. They start getting better and better at making good decisions that are good for the long term.